All right. So this is staying, this wall is coming down.
Okay.
And the upper half over here coming yep. down.
So this is where we need to focus.
Yeah. All right. I'm liking this.
What you thinking?
I can't really tell what's going on, like what's original. Erin?
Yep.
So.
Whoa.
Now, we are budgeted to sheetrock this all in.
But that's too pretty to cover.
This is Chicago brick.
Caroline specifically loves, like, natural texture. Let's just tear this whole fake thing down.
Okay.
And have this gorgeous old chimney.
Let's do it.
All okay. right, let's do it. Oh, I'm so excited. Because this house doesn't have any kind of identity, architecture-wise, because it's got so many identities, the living room wall takedown halfway situation is gonna establish that this house really does lean more craftsman. What in the world? Can I look?
Yes, come on.
Oh, man, yes, it looks good.
Yeah, we just need to clean it up.
So, we've gotta find a way to make the bookcase and this original chimney connect.
Yeah.
We can do that.
Yeah.
Oh, I love it, this is awesome. Good morning, sunshine.
Hey, how are y'all?
Good. This doesn't look like a good thing to have.
Well, it's a precaution, just to be safe. We weren't quite sure where the load was. We put that up there, but it all appears to be
okay.
Good to go.
I'm pretty excited about it.
I am too. Like, this is such a better situation. So here's what I'm thinking, all right?
Okay.
I want to bridge the gap between this chimney and this bookcase. I think it's gonna need to be woodwork.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then build up a box mantle that wraps all four sides of the chimney
okay.
to make it level with the top of the bookcase.
Okay, so the shelf carries onto the mantle.
Yes.
Okay.
Then we just have a craftsman columns on top of the bookcase on the right wall.
Okay.
Craftsman column on the left wall, and it just dies into the ceiling.
Okay.
And I don't, did y'all notice
did you see
this?
That?
No, what is
did you
that?
See what it says? January 2nd, 1906, Mississippi.
Oh, that is cool.
It's so pretty. So this is when the house was built. Somebody wrote that. If this could be saved.
Okay, we'll get that cut out and it's good. You think this will work?
We'll make it happen.
Cool.
Okay. Be easy. Perfect. Yeah. Oh! Oh man. It's so sweet. It's so cool. I mean, it's proof. The age of this house. Thank you so much. Hey, Miss Beth.
Hi, Erin. How are you?
I'm good. I've got a weird one for you today.
That's great.
Yeah. So this is a board we've pulled out. The original builder of the house wrote in chalk the date the house was being built.
That's fantastic.
Isn't that really
cool? That's a keepsake.
Cool?
Yes, it is. Very cool.
I want to make it a piece of art instead of just a board.
Okay. What kind of map would you like?
I would love for it to have a reveal that's like a deep cream color.
Well, we can do that. That's maybe too yellow.
Let's see. Ooh, this feels really good.
Mm-hmm. Okay. I have one that's deeper, but I don't think you need a deeper
no,
one.
No, I don't think so either. That feels kind of good because this is so rustic that I think it could be really cool if we go super fancy with the frame.
I think it would be too. And it's got the gold beads and this has got gold in it.
Yeah. Perfect.
All righty.
Thank you.
So, there's this really weird random wall of beadboard here. And I'm going to take it to the wood shop. And I'm gonna put some feet on it and it's gonna be a coffee table. It's gonna be awesome. All right, Chad, this wall of beadboard wasn't structural or anything. It was just suspended in the wall.
Interesting.
But it looked cool. And so I thought if we cleaned up the edges a little bit and then put some feet on it, make a little coffee table out of it.
Dude, I love it.
Do you want to work on getting this prepped? And I'm going to get our legs turned real quick.
Yep.
Okay. Corey and Caroline, they really like these dark wood finishes, but at the same time, they like story. They like something that tells a story. We're gonna cut it down to 4.5 feet. We're gonna trim up the sides a little bit, clean those up. put some legs on it and see how it looks.
Oh my. Awesome.
That was easy.
We did it.
This is the Burke's house.
Oh my gosh. God almighty. Look at that.
Oh my gosh, I love the porch. I love the color. That was perfect. Absolutely perfect. I love that y'all left the screen.
Just one section. It feels like the house is more balanced now.
This is amazing.
Does. It is absolutely amazing.
They're not really nice.
Oh my God.
The roof looks amazing.
I hope that you love
it. It's gorgeous. And I love the front door. Yeah. I mean, that is beautiful.
You guys have outdone yourselves.
Thank y'all.
Wow. Oh, absolutely.
You want to see inside? That's where it's real juicy.
Oh, yeah.
Let's go see the inside.
Come on.
You guys are not ready for this.
Come in.
Oh my gosh.
The floors.
Yeah.
Aren't they beautiful?
Beautiful. Honestly, this is one of my favorite paint colors ever.
I know how you feel about beige. Yeah. Wanted to give you what you needed.
This is insane.
When we pulled the paneling down,
it looked kind of like a hay barn.
Alrighty.
But we were able to preserve this one section here.
That is awesome. That.
And this light fixture is my favorite light fixture ever because Ben turned a sleeve tie-in with that beadboard on the stairs.
I love that.
It looks outstanding. American flag.
Yeah, that's your flag.
You guys nailed it.
Yeah. Pretty high on your priority list was the home office. We got that. Okay.
Yep.
Coming here. Man.
Whoa.
Oh my gosh.
It's not pink.
It is not pink.
Not even a little bit.
I love the dark.
Yeah.
And y'all cleaned up the fireplace screen.
We did.
This is so gorgeous.
This is great. Check out the desk, though. That is awesome.
We wanted it to feel like your store.
Yeah.
So these floors obviously continue right into here. They're throughout the house. That's the cool thing about this house.
Yeah. The wainscoting was here. These beams were here. The fireplace was here. They were just disguised.
The pink thing?
The pink thing.
Come on into your living room.
Oh my gosh.
Come on in.
This is amazing. Oh my gosh, in the fireplace.
Wow. That was there. It was
this is
there.
Amazing. And y'all kept the built-ins.
Yeah.
This is awesome, guys.
This is amazing.
Seriously. It took a minute for the brain to kind of process all that.
Can you even remember how it was before?
I don't want to. I don't want to remember how it was before.
Kick back. Prop your feet up.
Well, I'm at home now.
This came out of the house. Frame the top and put some feet on it.
I have to touch this. I cannot believe this is still here.
To the dining room?
To the dining room.
Come see.
That is amazing.
Yes, it's a double-sided fireplace, or it was, but it is at least beautiful again.
Yeah. This built-in on this side of the china cabinet, we rebuilt it to match the built-ins on the other side.
I love that.
Wow.
But the really big surprise that we found was this board.
Yes, and it's the date of when the house was built.
Oh, wow.
Yep, the builder wrote it January 2nd, 1906.
Mississippi.
Wow.
And my grandmother's china.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've always wanted a place to display it.
In the kitchen, the chimney inspired some things.
What? In the world.
Wow. This is getting me more than any. I mean, I absolutely love it. Like, y'all picked out of my brain, like, everything I love.
That is my favorite thing to hear. You have no idea how much that means to me. These countertops feel so good.
I love this.
Check this out.
You like that?
Oh, yeah.
The two sides here, these are your cabinet doors.
Are you serious?
The cabinet doors were they were kind of 90s.
Yeah.
But they work perfect this way.
I absolutely love it.
So the brick is actually from the fireplace that we pulled off. We had to supplement a little bit.
So we wanted to make that kind of the focal point over your stove.
Absolutely love
that
it.
That is too perfect. Too perfect.
We made some glass doors for your pantry so you can display.
Check that out.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
I can't believe we get to live here.
Seriously, though.
Get to live here.
You told us that, you know, your budget was $150,000. You got the house for $80,000, and then we spent $63,000 on the renovation, bringing your all-in total to $143,000, which is still less than your all-in budget.
Yeah, it's very cool.